Would you recommend a prong on a small little dog to reinforce heel? She's about 12 pounds, super short hair. Nervous about her pulling and hurting her neck, as I've never used one before.
Yeah, prong collar won't hurt the dog's neck. Okay. Here's a good example, guys, about when you first got a dog. Is it okay to bonk a dog? Let me give everyone a wonderful example. You ready? You bring a dog home to your house. You walk in the house. You have a cat. It walks over to the cat. The cat makes a hissing noise, whacks it across the face. The dog's been in your house for 57 seconds. Was that fair? Sure. Why? Well, number one, it was nature. Nature's cruel, but nature's nature. So should we have told the cat, whoa, 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 whoa. That's not acceptable. You need to wait until week three before you slap the dog. The cat's like, no, the dog was coming at me. I didn't like that dog in my space. I'm going to let this other animal know in a way that we both understand to get out of my space. And the cat deployed what it does. And then the dog said, I got no fucking problem with you, lady. At all. You can have all the space for the next 10 years. That's how powerful a properly applied pressure is. Look at that. Hey, how are you, everybody? Hey, everybody. How's everybody doing? We're going live. Hey, we're live. Look at that. How's everybody doing? Hey, how are you? What the heck? You came in here. Where's the show? You came in here last minute all huffing and puffing. Where'd you come from?
Getting ready. Very long day.
Get ready.
Worked past my 8 hours as always.
Uh-oh. That's not allowed. Okay. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman, solid canine training with my, I keep saying weekly, with three times a week.
I don't think you say that.
Maybe.
I think you imagine it in your
head. You know what it is? You know what it is? Back when I had my radio show, I said.
You should maybe go watch the replays and see what you actually But I said.
I used to say my weekly call-in radio show, but that goes on from that. So how's everybody doing? The show is going to run for 90 minutes. This is Joelle. She is one of the trainers at the training center. She does a ton of social media. She's actually building a nice little social media group in the company for herself. She also travels to all the seminars with me. So you'll see her in all the seminars. And if you wonder where all the photos and the videos that are being taken, that's her. Co-host on the show. So it's always fantastic to have her here. It's always fantastic to do the show. It's almost like it's exhausting as it is. It's like stress relief.
Yeah.
It really is. Yeah, it really is. Maybe because I yell so much.
Probably. Meanwhile, I just have to keep it all in over here.
And put up with me, which adds layers of stress to your life. This is not stress relief for you, Jeff. Like
counting down till the gym.
So you ask a question, we give an answer. There's a little say something box down there. Say something. Joel will read it. I'll ask it. There is a dollar sign. The dollar sign is there called Top Chat, Super Chat. Thank you all for the folks that do that. What it does is it's something that YouTube offers creators like ourselves. It offers so much free content for people, but it does bump your question up to the top. Some people ask a question. Some people don't. Some people just appreciate the thousands of videos we put out there for free. But we try to get through every single question possible. You'll notice, but so there's a lot of questions. Also, you can go to Jeff Gellman Seminars, jeffgellmanseminars.com, and you can see the tour. We're going to be in Reno next weekend, and then Canton, Ohio, and then Collingwood, Ontario, Canada. So we've got three coming up. We're doing 25 this year. The seminars and the show talk a lot about punishments because most people want us to stop onto behaviors. So if you're brand new to the show, if you're brand new to my world, you hear the word punishment. Now people need to understand what punishment is, how to properly apply an aversive. They need to really understand that. So in order to do that, it is something you'll want to learn and we teach it. So most of the questions are going to be how to apply a punisher because most people in the show want me to stop and unwanted behavior. So here we go.
You know what I found out today?
What?
That skincare line I use is based out of Ontario. We might have to make a pit stop.
We make a lot of pit stops. We have time. But guess what? Just to let you know, Ontario, it's a big place. Okay.
We storefront there, though.
That we can do. It's like, oh yeah, so you know, you're heading out to California. Hey, go visit my Uncle John. It's like, where does he live? Oh, I don't know. Ask for Uncle John. Yes. But there's a lot of storefronts there.
Dana Walters.
Hey, Dana.
Look who it is. Hey, Jeff, great weekend in Elkhart. We are off to a great start with Zoe. My question is for my brother. He has a pity, sweet, but not much training, and a cat. They play rough. My parents are about to move in with them, and their snotty is Shih Tzu mix. How to best introduce them all?
Move them all outside. The strongest one will survive. Let that one come back in. There's a lot of variables, Dana. This is what I would do, Dana. Stay out of it. The best advice you can do is pass my information on to the parties that are affected by this. Okay. And have that. And that's not because I don't want to give you the answer, but there's a lot of variables here. So they play rough. Rough play is not aggressive play. They need to learn how to turn off rough play. They should be having massive structure. Bringing a brand new dog into the house is an unknown factor. It could be a shit show, all depending on their skill set. And then there's also a bunch of humans that are involved. Next.
Hostway, I was listening to your podcast from May 6th and heard me say, what do you think of dog parks? It was not me, and I was being framed. I hate dog parks, and that was another Hostway. Also, love you both.
I don't know, Hostway. We just think every Hostway is you. It's not a very common name. Next.
Holding on dog training. Hey, Ashley.
Hey, Ashley. How are you? How's the non-smoking? Did you stop yet?
Did you pick up any other habits?
Pick up the habits.
Have a submissive dog who melts into the floor of her kennel and basically pours herself out when I go to get her. Once collar on, she's completely fine. It's getting annoying. Bonker.
No. Put a leash on the dog, collar on the dog, in the kennel, do kennel drills. So let's go. Recall. Kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. Let's go. You can do it with food and a clicker. And a leash.
Tommy says, hi, guys.
Hey, Tommy.
Melissa says, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Melissa. Great Skype today. I'm feeling great about all this.
Dog works. Opinion of methods to teach a young puppy to walk on a loose leash.
Okay.
Opinion of methods. Like, what do you suggest?
We have to define young puppy. So if the puppy doesn't pull, just a leash and a collar and walk the dog. There's all different methods. Use the method that works for you. I don't know your skill set. But there is a reason why you can't use a prong collar on a 14-week-old puppy and up. But it all depends. Just keep in mind, we're training these dogs to be adults. And a lot of dogs will start out walking well, and then they start walking terribly because they get heavier. If a dog pulls on a flat buckle collar, you can hurt the dog. Martingale, you can hurt the dog. Choke chain, you can hurt the dog. Prong collars are fine. They're safe. They're great things for puppies. We don't train on harnesses. You really can't train a dog on a harness. You can't communicate. So, you know how I train. So how I would train a puppy is how I would train a puppy. So I don't know how other people are training puppies. Next.
Mary. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey.
Hey, Mary. Nina, 10-month old boxer, watched all of Sean O'Shea videos and thousands of yours. Bought prong and e-collar, mini educator. Skull has 3-hour place, comes to work with me, stop jumping, sits down, and places.
Awesome. Congratulations. Good job.
Michelle, good evening, Jeff and Joelle. Nice to see you back home after the long road trip.
Yes. It wasn't that long. You know, I used to be on the road for 2 months at a time back in the day.
How did you not get back issues? Like just driving?
Yeah. I stretched.
God, my lower back is like wrecked from 12 days.
Next.
Nina, 2 problems. I have dropped food a few times, and it's a free-for-all of my 12 and 13-year-old dogs. Can otherwise no resource guarding at all. How can I tie back, set up, and use out command with high level?
So all I would do is this. I would get a couple of bonkers. Bonker is a wrapped-up towel like this. Okay. Drop food on the ground. Dogs go to get the food, say no extremely firmly, boom. Get a double bonker, boom, boom. Just like that, release. I'll be making a bonker video, guys, pretty soon. I'm going to put it up on my Patreon account. So I'll be making full, but we actually have tons of video footage of me bonking dogs. So we're going to put a little compilation together. I'll put it up on my Patreon account next.
Dana and Triumph with Zoe. I turned up the correction and she now takes me seriously. Three successful walks with no reactivity except for some huffing and puffing. Joelle, your hair looks amazing. You too, Jeff.
So Dana, think about it. That's all you had to do. That's all you had to do. Same shit I've been telling you to do. It was great to see you, you know, and I've never seen a man make love to a dog in public before. So it was great to see your husband. next. He didn't really make love to the dog. Dana knows what I'm talking about. And anybody at the seminar knows what I'm talking about. Next.
Hallie. Hello. I introduced my dog to the pool today, but she wouldn't jump in. She ran around excitedly and pawed at it like she wanted to get in, but she just wouldn't. Any advice to get her in?
Yes.
We'll post a video on it.
Follow my video on YouTube. So watch. Most dogs won't jump in a pool. I've got a very specific way to teach a dog how to swim. It works 100% of the time. I've got a video on in-ground pool, above-ground pool, lake, stream. You can also use it for the ocean as well. You just have to watch out because of the salt water. Dogs can throw up sometimes, and they can also get dehydrated if they ingest so much. But I've got a very specific videos, very specific technique. It's all done on a leash. Next.
Top chat.
Top chat. $5. Tommy, my lab pit mix 1 year gets way too excited when guests come over, but behaves very well when just us. How do I go about fixing this? That's very common. It's called arousal. It's extremely common. It's arousal. So number one, does your dog know place? If your dog doesn't know place, teach it place. Places. Now, there's a couple ways you can do this. You can just stop the arousal by bonking the dog. No, bonk. Dog stops the arousal. And I've got videos on how to make a bonker, how to use a bonker. So you'll want to do that. Then what you can do is you can teach place. Watch a video. Place means go to a mat. Go to a mat and lie down. I got something in the oven. Hold on 1 second. Go ahead. Do the question. Linda. Oven. All right, just in case.
Carlin, I was asking my fellow balance trainers a question and realized a lot of my colleagues just don't think quite as deep as you guys. Thank you for critical thinking.
You're welcome. Yeah, most people don't. Any trainers don't think. They don't think state of mind. What I'm finding is a lot of dog trainers don't think state of mind. And they focus more on, they don't focus as much as on the human element as they do on the dog element. So those are two big things. Next.
Allison, what size pet cot would you recommend buying for a German Shepherd? Getting a puppy and not sure if I need a large and XL for long term.
I have no idea how large the dog is going to grow because some German Shepherds grow huge. So historically, a large is usually enough. Extra large ones are huge. Also depends on the brand. Next.
Ryan, hi guys. Happy Wednesday. It's in place while full laundry and listening, making progress with your advice.
Awesome. Good to hear.
Dana, seminars rock. Do it, people.
Awesome. Yeah, it was a great seminar. Thank you. Mm. Elkhart, Indiana. Photo album went up last night.
I noticed. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Deanna, dog went after someone who accidentally stepped on its tie out, causing its head to be pulled down. Was this an appropriate reaction? Should it have been corrected?
No. I mean, it's not acceptable behavior. I'm not surprised by it. I'm not surprised by it. You could have corrected the dog. I mean, I wouldn't probably want to role play that over and over and over again. When you say tie out, does that mean like tied out to back in the backyard or tie out like in the house, like a tie back? So I mean, if it's in the yard, I mean, that means it's probably pretty long. So, you know, depends how forceful they step down on it as well. So there's a lot of factors. It might have just been like a bad situation. Next.
Doug, hey guys, love the show. Practicing walking my 12-week GSD indoors, choking himself on martingale. Turning around doesn't work, pop doesn't work, and stopping doesn't work. Any tips?
Yeah, get rid of your martingale. You can switch to a prong collar if you want to, 2 to 5 millimeter. But also, you know, we don't, like, it's okay to not have a good walk yet. I mean, don't want the pulling, but I want you working on sit, down, place, tons of recall. You can do some focus work in and out of the crate. shutting up the crate, and just do follow. Have the dog just follow you around in directional changes. Next.
Susan, where can I read about raw diet?
The internet. So go to Karma Vore, Karma Vore. Read there. They're a good source. Next.
Caitlin, how do you work with a fearful dog who has been abused by a previous owner? She's not aggressive in any way, just extremely timid and uncertain in new places and sometimes even in her own home.
Okay. So first of all, I want you to never repeat that she was abused by her previous owner. Never. Never say those words again. It's a non-factor. It literally is a non-factor. Anybody that says, oh, no, it's not. I'm like, you don't know what you're talking about then, frankly. It's a non-factor. Number one, most people will say that their dog was abused and they have no knowledge of the abuse whatsoever. They just heard it from somebody. And also, some people think something's abuse, but it's not abuse. There's many ways to abuse an animal. So they assume that because of the fear. And even if someone did beat the shit out of the dog, of course that's terrible. That's horrific. But the dog in front of us is a fearful, nervous dog. That's what we address, the fearful, nervous dog right in front of us. So don't repeat that, because when you repeat that, what's going to happen is it's going to put a mental block in your head that the day that dog growls at you, you may not correct it appropriately because you feel bad because it was someone else abused it. You don't want to be that person. And that's why dogs end up in shelters, because people hold on to the story, too much love and affection, not enough structure, guidance, leadership, and absolutely not enough properly applied punishment for something that's dangerous. So now, how do you fix fear? Lots of confidence building and doing stuff. And train with a lot with your head, barely any with your heart. And this sounds bold and uncaring. No. I'm trying to create a confident, well-adjusted dog that will stay in the home for the rest of its natural life. That's how much I care about the dog. I just know nothing in my heart, decision-making, is going to do it. It's all logic. It's all dog training. And it's not easy, because you will be making that dog uncomfortable working through its stress. So you have to be comfortable with that. What do? If you can get food drive out of that dog, get food drive out of that dog, and you work that dog on all its basic commands, always on a leash, ask the dog to do lots of things. Next.
Cody, 50-pound GSD, bought the 3-millimeter Herm Springer prong collar. Had to take 3 links out, could almost take a 4th out. Do I need to go down in size?
No, that's common. 2 on one side, 1 on the other. Next.
Svenja, moved my schedule around to be here for the live better than any TV show.
Awesome. That's smart person. Smart person. You'll have to tell that date of yours. They'll just have to wait. Next.
Brandy, at the park, I heard a woman shout a name twice. I turn around to see this fluffy thing, probably as big as a Pomeranian, darting towards us. Dog jumped up a few times as if startled, then sat immediately by my command and ignored the thing bouncing on his back and near his face. The lady came over with a horrible apology and said, sorry, he got off the leash. The nonchalant attitude. What would Jeff do?
What's up?
I'm not your personal fucking chef.
Okay, hold on here, Linda.
I told you I wanted fucking nothing to do with this shit.
Listen.
And you stick me with it.
Listen. Listen to me.
Puts a fucking pork tenderloin in the oven when
he goes to hop
stop,
on the chef.
Stop. I had pork tenderloin. It needed an increase from 135 to 145. I had to do the show in 3 minutes. I put the pork tenderloin back in there, and I said, can you please, listen, I said, can you please keep an eye on it? You said, no problem at all. So I'm sitting up here, and I'm like.
Number one, you didn't ask me. Number two, I said, you know I'm gonna keep an eye on that fucking pork loin, right?
I did ask you that, and that was your response. Now, I'm sitting here doing the show, and I'm thinking to myself, she's such a busy person. She just had a kid come home. She's making dinner, she's taking care of stuff, she's doing a great job keeping the house and taking care of the kids. The pork tenderloin is probably the last thing on her mind. So I was in the middle of a question. I excused myself politely. I opened up the door and I just said, I wasn't going to say, hey, honey, can you check on the pork tenderloin? I literally wanted to say like a code word, pork tenderloin. Or oven, and you knew what I was talking about. I wasn't ringing a bell. I wasn't like dialing up for a fucking pizza. I was trying to be really, really nice. I'm sorry.
Listen.
Can I finish my show?
I stick the freaking thermometer in.
Yes.
It's barely hitting 140 on one part. Stick it in somewhere else. It's like 155. I'm done. It's out of the oven.
Okay, great.
Whatever's going to happen All right. is going to happen.
Cool. Okay, how many times did you stick it in?
The pork's out of the oven.
Thanks.
And Joelle's drinking her own urine.
Right, this is such a weird color for a thing, isn't it?
Okay. Thank you. All right. What was the question?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Okay.
The dog off leash.
I don't think she was nonchalant. I mean, she was probably being. If she was nonchalant, I'd be like, listen, everybody makes a mistake. At least she apologized, right? She said she was sorry. At least she apologized. Like, some people don't even apologize. So, next.
I think my neck hurts from always cranking it to look at you. I think we're going to have to switch sides eventually.
Like, every other show?
Oh, it hurts really bad.
Well, stop looking at me.
C-Dubs Fitness. Any good tips on rehabbing an extremely scared dog, only afraid of people, he just runs away? I'm starting with tons of structure. Thank you. Thanks, Jeff. You're the man.
Yeah, keep a leash on the dog. Any flight risk dog, keep a leash on the dog. Do a clicker food stuff. You know, so hang out somewhere in public on a bench. Keep people away. Your dog's sitting next to you. Every time a person walks by, click food. Next.
Carl. Hi, Jeff. I have a Pasadale Terrier? Pasadale Terrier?
All I know is this. Nobody wants fucking Lynn pissed off at them. That's all I'm saying.
What size prong collar will I need? I will use your tutorials on how to use collar on dog to stop bad walking and bad behavior.
How many pounds is the dog?
I don't know. I don't know what a freaking Pasadale Terrier is. The fuck's a Pasadale?
So anything below about 45 or 50 pounds, probably the 2.25 millimeter next.
Tommy, hi guys, love the show. Super helpful. My lab pit mix gets way too excited when guests come over, but behaves when alone. How do I go about fixing this?
We already answered that for somebody else. Eliminate the arousal. No leash pop, no bonk. Great, arousal's gone. Now tell the dog what to do. Go to place. It's not bad dog, go to place. It's not when you're aroused, go to place. It's now you're calm, but go to place anyway. Next.
Mackins, hello J&J. When leash correcting during structured walk, my 16-month-old American bully pulls after a few moments after prong collar correction. Only started 3 weeks ago. When should I expect no pulling?
Well, probably never if you're keeping this up, because it should pretty much go away pretty soon. You're most likely underwhelming the dog. So, and then also, what's the rest of your day look like? Are you demanding the rest of the day? Are you letting your dog free roam? Are you letting your dog blow through basic commands? Are you letting your dog just blow in and out of a crate? Are you doing any other impulse control exercises at all? Or are you just giving your dog a free for all? You don't have to really follow any of my rules. I'm treating dog training like trick training. But on the walk, I want you to stop this behavior. So it's all sort of universal. But if every day you just correct, the dog comes back and then surges forward, it's always going to look like that. So let's stop that pattern. Next.
Crixis. Hi, guys. It's always good to be home.
Hey.
Hey, Crixis. Yep. Kaylee J. Good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Kaylee J. How are you?
Brandy. I already read that.
Yep.
Rachel. My dog trainer thinks prong collars fall off too easily. It needs a backup collar. Any experience with prongs falling off?
I don't have any, but having a backup collar, a carabiner hooked from the dead ring to flat buckle collar or a martingale or something else is a good idea. So they don't fall. I mean, I wouldn't make that statement that they fall off too easily, because I mean, I've never seen it happen. I watched once at a seminar, a collar popped off. I didn't put it on. I didn't double check the equipment. So that's an error right there.
That was the leash itself though.
Was it the leash or the collar?
The leash actually. Like unclipped.
Oh, unclipped.
And they had the backup on the leash thing.
Got it. Next.
Hey, it's Christy. Ah, all caps. It's Jeff. Can't believe I'm catching you guys live. I have a 5-year-old Doberman who does not like the crate and pants a lot. Should I just leave him in there until he gets over it?
That's a hard one. Like, This is the thing with panting and like salivating. So panting and salivating, what you need to really do is this. Is the dog at least lying down with its head down? So do the double down. So have the dog lie down with its head down. Also, guys, if you haven't subscribed to the show, hit your notifications. The way YouTube is working out with other algorithms, if you don't hit notifications, a lot of the times you won't be notified of this show. All right, thanks.
Is that it?
Yeah, the head down. Yep.
Okay.
Yep, I'm going to do that for now. That's the advice I'm going to give you for now. Yep.
Clayton, Atlanta seminar was a game changer for how my wife and I handle our black whiny dog. The pre-walk bonk. Do it, people. It works. Thank you, Jeff.
Pre-walk bonk. Yep. I'm telling you, so many people. Guys, I'm very aware of the conversation out there on bonking and everything else I do. I'm not ignorant. I've seen the screenshots. I hear the messages. I ignore it all because I know what I'm doing is good work and it's correct. It's helping people. And the people that are actually doing this stuff are getting dramatic changes. Next.
Dog Works donated $1.99.
Oh, well, thanks, Dog Works.
35-pound golden doodle pulls.
One more time.
12-week-old, 35-pound golden doodle pulls.
So a 12 weeks old, 35 pounds already?
That's pretty big.
That's going to be a big fucking dog. Damn. Get yourself a 2.25 millimeter. Next.
Nina, I already read that one too, right?
I don't know.
Did I?
I'm not following.
Okay. No, she just keeps saying the dog's names, but just looking there. Skull or any of my other dogs were never kenneled. Bought one for Skull a few days ago. Put him in at work. Less distractions. He fights going in, and then he pants and pants for hours. E-collar corrected at... shoot, it's all broken up.
Okay, so what I want you to do is this. Practice kennel drills in and out of the kennel. It's an obedience command. So kennel up, they go in. And this is all done on a leash. And it's one step at a time. Kennel up. And then they're in the kennel, then they lie down, and then open up the door. They can't rush out. Door closes really fast. Open up the door, release. Come on out, do a sit. Again, repeat. When the dog is in there, have it lie down. Remember, are you doing any other duration work any other time of the day? Guys, remember this phrase. What's the rest of the day look like? Always remember that. Dog training is not one thing. It's everything. Next.
Tommy, hey guys, love the show. Super helpful. My lab pit mix, 1 year. Gets way too excited when guests come over, but behaves very well.
Now, this is like the same question for the last.
How do I go about fixing this?
I answered it twice already. Okay. Next.
Betty, thank you. My kind of corso no longer jumps on anyone. Love
awesome.
You guys.
Awesome. Next.
Shane, how to shut your dog up from barking when someone knocks. I'm okay with alarm barking, but then I want him to stop.
Teach it to shut up. Number one, you can use a bunker. You would say no. And bunk. Next. Remote collar. No. Correct. Bark collar. Next.
Donde says hello.
Hey, Donde. How are you?
Sarah, I'm trying to start training and I want to start working lots of dogs, as you say. Do I need to get an LLC or other legal stuff set up first, even if it's for free?
If free doesn't matter. You still have a liability issue. So, I mean, you can also volunteer at a shelter, but the shelters don't, or a rescue. I mean, you can just start working with rescue, you know, a small rescue. You can just start working with those dogs, help out those dogs. I mean, if you want to start a business, yeah, you can get an LLC. You can get, you know, I definitely won't do a sole proprietor, but that's, don't take legal advice or accounting advice from a dog trainer. Talk to your lawyer, talk to your CPA about that. Work with as many dogs as you want, whether it's free or pay doesn't matter. Maybe it does matter in a court of law, but just from a liability standpoint, it's probably better. Next.
Donde, seeing while my dog's eating.
Awesome.
Abby.
Put up a screenshot of that up and tag us on your Instagram. Guys, if you put us up on your Instagram stories and tag us, we'll share it on our stories. Next.
Abby, one-year-old plot hound is extremely aggressive towards other dogs. Trainer we're working with says to redirect the treat when she shows signs of aggression. It hasn't helped. Thoughts, can't take her anywhere for fear of her biting another dog.
Okay, don't tell me who the trainer is because I don't want to know. It's more about the philosophy. That's the stupidest fucking advice you can ever give in the world. I can't imagine stupider advice than that. Let's think about this logically. Are you ready? I'm not attacking you and I'm not mad at you, but I'm sick and fucking tired of these fucking trainers. All right, who are probably certified, by the way, probably with a fancy degree, letters after their name, who have no fucking idea how to stop an unwanted behavior. And it ain't fucking rocket science to stop one. Yes, I'm pissed off. Why? Because what's this person's name?
Abby.
Because Abby's dog is going to end up dead because of this shit ass fucking advice she's getting. And everybody else out there that's getting the same shit ass fucking advice to redirect aggression is going to end up with a dead damn dog as well. And everybody should be pissed off. So, your dog is aggressive and you present food. Food is a reward. What will you get more of? More aggressive behavior. When I want more of something, I present a reward to the dog. We are rewarding dogs all day long with food as well. We clicker train dogs, food train dogs. When I want the dog to teach something new, I use food, but not teach to not bite. It's not the way it works. Not while the dog is thinking of biting. The dog's state of mind says, I want to bite you. And then what do? Oh, well, here's food for that fucking thought. And you will get more of it. It will not work. It does not work. It has never worked. Now, you apply a proper punisher, which is literally no remote collar stim, rockets fucking world. No bonk to rockets fucking world. Oh, that sucked, didn't it? So growling a dog sucks, right? Sure does, Jeff. Cool. Now let's see what happens next time. Hey, person with dog, walk by. Dog goes, hey, Jeff, look at me. No growling. That's a good choice. Click food. Now you apply your food. Got it? Yep. I'm pissed. Because Abby's dog is going to get killed if she keeps this up. And so is everybody else's out there. Next. Next. What?
Stefan. Hi, the thing is, I have a 2-year-old level dog, great with kids and adults, but some that say neuter him, some say don't. It causes more health problems doing it. What's your opinion?
I mean, every vet, first of all, I'm not a vet. So bottom line is this. Dogs are dying of cancer left and right. They've all been fixed. Right? Dogs are dying. We see tons of aggressive dogs out there. Most of them are fixed. It's a personal choice whether you want to desex your dog. Next.
Jenna, what do you think about dogs being left outside unattended, livestock guardian, and working dogs as an exception?
I have no problem at all. I've got a dog that lives outside unattended. I have no problem. He lives outside. He's got a fenced-in area, got a heated doghouse, walks around, hangs out, lies down on the deck, oversees the yard. I have no problem with outside dogs. Most dogs in this country are outside dogs. You know, people in cities, we have our houses inside, but tons of dogs are outside. I have absolutely no problem with that at all. Next.
James, a leash in the water. Can you elaborate on that? Probably like when you teach dogs.
Oh, yeah. Watch my video on YouTube. Guys, you have to use a leash to train a dog. It's much easier to use a leash. So watch my YouTube videos. Next.
Monoxide, 1-year-old Rottweiler. We bought a chew toy for her and she just started carrying it around whining. Should I correct the whine or just take the chew toy away? She didn't do this with deer antlers.
It could be excitement. So have her go lie down, see what happens. You know, I mean, you could correct the whining, but you know, to me, I mean, my dogs don't have toys other than chuck it toys. So we play chuck it and we play, I throw a ball in the water. So we pretty much just play fetch with toys. Other than that, they really don't have any toys. But I'm not against toys. If a dog didn't whine with a deer antler and it whines with a toy, you could make your life easier. Freaking don't give the dog the toy if you don't want to. Next.
John Pollard, the pack leader. Hey, y'all. I've been wanting to change my dog's diet from kibble to a raw food diet. Is it possible to change a dog's diet to raw once they've grown up? If so, how would you go about changing it? By the way, love these podcasts.
Thank you so much, John. Yes, most people don't change to raw until till the dog is an older dog. But I'm not an expert on raw. Go to Karmavore, Karmavore, pet.nutrition on Instagram. Next.
Crixis, does being the runt of the litter lead to more behavioral issues? Was just wondering.
I have no idea. I have no idea. I'll put it this way. Every dog we come in contact with on a training center has got behavioral issues. I bet you they weren't the runts. That would be weird, right? Like statistically. So it probably has no effect. Next.
Angela used e-collar on my 75-pound GSD, and it doesn't even matter to her. It's like it's not even on.
So I don't know the brand. I don't know your skill set. Did you fit it properly? Is the neck piece turned on? I'm being serious. Did you actually turn it on? Is the handset being turned on? But if you don't have good contact, it won't work. But also, I don't know what the brand is. We like e-collar technology and dog trust. So chances are it's at least one of those because that goes up to 127. But it could be contact. If on a German Shepherd, you probably need thick fur contact points, and it should be super, super snug. Also, what are you trying to communicate with your dog? A lot of dogs will feel it, but they won't make any obvious recognition of it. But I can usually tell if they're feeling it or not. But chances are it fits. That's usually the number one mistake people make is improper fit. Next.
The Keppel, is it possible to reverse dog reaction all the way to the other spectrum, such as dog friendly at a dog park? I've only been successful with a prong collar when walking around other dogs.
I would never take a dog to a dog park at all because there's too many unknown variables, all the other dogs being one of them. Next. But sorry, can you take a dog that was highly reactive to playful? Yes, you can. The problem is in a dog park, there's way too many unknown variables. Next.
Candy, I've been using e-collar on my 1-year-old pit bull and has already eliminated a lot of his leash reactivity problems, but his hair raises up when he sees a dog. Should I correct that as well?
Yes, you do. That's the first sign of arousal. Next.
Mario, hi guys. Got my ticket for the San Francisco seminar, T3 later in the future.
Awesome, Mario.
Meanwhile, I'm training as many dogs as I can get a hold of.
Fantastic. Mario, we'll see you there. That's going to be a good one. Glad you got a ticket. Working spots sold out. There's still audit spots. There's a bunch of seminars that are sold out, working spots. Mm-hmm. Collingwood sold out, I believe. San Francisco is sold out. There's only two that are definitely sold out for working spots. Next. Alaska's getting, we want to come up to Alaska. Alaska and Hawaii are looking good. Next.
Jackie, my well-behaved 4-year-old lab hates our 12-week-old lab puppy. She's attacked his face twice with substantial damage. No warning, like big eyes, ears down, nothing, just attack.
Okay, keep them separate. I can't help you on this show tonight. Keep them separate. I don't want that dog anywhere around that puppy. End of story, non-negotiable. Next.
Bo Boatner. Is there any reason not to start bonking a dog from the first day of training, owning him?
Well, if he does something bad, we often bonk a dog on day one of board and train because they're out of control. So if you bring home a dog that's out of control, why not? If you're presented with a behavioral problem in front of you, you address the behavioral problem in front of you. Whether you've had the dog for an hour, a year, or 10 years. I'm addressing your behavior. Your behavior warrants a reward or a punishment. It's as simple as that. And you really don't have to factor in many other things. The problem is everybody else wants to factor all these things in. So, you know, would I bonk an 8-week-old puppy? In a crate, I would. If it was in a crate, I'd bonk the crate. But let's forget about that. But when we're talking most behaviors with most dogs, yeah, it's acceptable. Next.
Slides and spoons. Would you recommend a prong on a small little dog to reinforce heel? She's about 12 pounds, super short hair. Nervous about her pulling and hurting her neck, as I've never used one before.
Yeah, prong collar won't hurt the dog's neck. Okay. Here's a good example, guys, about when you first got a dog. is okay to bonk a dog. Let me give everyone a wonderful example. You ready? You bring a dog home to your house. You walk in the house. You have a cat. It walks over to the cat. The cat makes a hissing noise, whacks it across the face. The dog's been in your house for 57 seconds. Was that fair? Sure. Why? Well, number one, it was nature. Nature's cruel, but nature's nature. So should we have told the cat, whoa, that's not acceptable. You need to wait until week three before you slap the dog. The cat's like, no, the dog was coming at me. I didn't like that dog in my space. I'm going to let this other animal know in a way that we both understand to get out of my space. And the cat deployed what it does. And then the dog said, I got no fuck problem with you, lady, at all. You can have all the space for the next 10 years. That's how powerful a properly applied pressure is. $24.99, Diana, I love your show. I just love all that you guys do. I work in the dog grooming world, and man, you probably have some skills. Dog groomers, skills. I deal with tons of pure positive nonsense on a daily basis. Sometimes I need to hear your voice just to keep my sanity. Thanks for all you do. And so, Diana, don't forget, you can get my podcast on, you can get me on Spotify, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, and Google Platform. Your earbuds, listen to me all day long. Next.
Hi, Jeff. Oh, this is Anna. Thank you for your free content. Incorporated the pre-walk bonk, and it's been amazing on a seven-month-old doodle.
Nice.
Should I limit how much affection my two girls give him?
Girls, I'm thinking you're thinking your children. Just be careful. I mean, this is the thing. Nobody got a dog not to be affectionate with it. 100% agree with that statement. I say that all the time. But we also didn't get a dog to bite people. We also didn't get a dog to bark all night. We also didn't get a dog to piss and shit in the house all the time. We also didn't get a dog to struggle with leash reactivity. We also didn't get a dog to struggle with separation anxiety. Okay? So what I like to do is this. Yes, the kids can pet the dog, but also get those kids to hang out with the dog and read to the dog. Put the dog in it down. Put the dog in the place. Hey, kids, pull up a pillow. Come here. Read some books. Read some books to the dog. Teach them calming stuff for the dog. Also, teach them how to walk the dog. Teach them how to like play chuck it or toss a toy for the dog. Teach the dog to have a soft mouth around the kids. Do things like that. Next.
Top chat.
$9.99. Dino, mob. Left three-part message about baby and Samoy. Dino, don't try to butter me up with them long fucking messages. Next.
I guess we'll see.
Be healed. See what kind of mood I'm in. Next.
Be healed dog training. Hello, hey. From Indiana. Tuning in while walking my giant self up and down the driveway with client dogs.
Left. Giant. Oh, shit. She's pregnant again.
Who's Be Healed dog training?
You've never met her?
I think. Is that Rachel?
Yeah.
She's pregnant again?
Yeah. She was pregnant last time I saw her. She was pregnant. Where did I see her last?
South
somewhere.
Carolina?
And she was like, she said something about like being pregnant
was
again.
She?
I'm pretty sure.
Like her baby was young.
Hey, who is that? Angelo?
Yeah.
Come here, Ange. Kira here. Okay, come here.
Good night, Papa.
I love you, buddy. Good night.
Good night, Joelle.
Good night, Angelo.
Hey, say we're on YouTube Live. Say goodbye.
Good night, YouTube Live.
Okay. See you later.
Yeah.
No pants. Right. Hello from Indiana. Tuning in while walking. Oh,
yeah, we do that.
Last group of dogs before maternity leave in June. Owen will be here.
So. Yeah, look at that. Huh. Nice.
Scattered Storm says hello.
Hey, Scattered Storm.
I'm losing my voice. Juan. Hi, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Juan.
Just saying hi tonight. Looking forward to meeting you guys at the Reno seminar.
Oh, Reno's going to be good. Next.
Tanya, why does my husky have a crazy run around burst of energy in my house after a long walk? Should I allow it?
I wouldn't. I'm not a big fan of any dog running around a house alone, a husky. So no, I'd put a stop to that. Next.
Xavier, my 1 year husky has been fully off leash since he was 5 months, but after watching a recent podcast about working more duration work with a young GSD, made me realize I had a lot more work to do. Thank you.
Hey, man, we all got a lot of work to do, so don't worry about that. You know, the fact that you're working so hard with that dog, kudos to you, but we always can work on stuff. Next.
Chloe, I have a foster dog who's quite large, GSD Dane. He's only about a year old and isn't understanding his own size and keeps bullying the other dogs. Keep using the e-collar in place.
Yeah, make it suck to do that. I would. We'd actually use a stockyard whip on the dog's butt. If it started doing that, we'd go like that in a socialization yard. Next.
She said, among other basic training, he's also very dramatic and likes to scream and act like I'm killing him, especially when corrected with the prong. He also likes to block you out once off leash.
Yeah. So he's a pushy, snotty dog who's a drama queen. So work him through it all. Don't let his dramatic responses, and some people are like, that's because it hurts. No. I've had dogs on slip leads that you give the tiniest bit of lead. It's so funny. You get a dog that will drag your ass down the street on a slip lead, but if it's next to you and you give it a little bit of upward pressure, it's like, oh my God, the end of the world. It's called an objection. So work them through it. Next.
Turn a dog training, put laugh crying emojis.
Oh, cool.
Hey, it's Christy. I love your podcast and YouTube videos. I've been binge watching and listening like crazy. Thanks for everything you do. I foster Dobermans and your advice has helped so incredibly much.
Awesome, Christy. Proud of you. Thanks for the kind words.
Shane. Jerry, LOL, about pork tenderloin. Jerry's your show. Sean says, ha ha. Lindsay says, oh my God, Linda, love you guys.
Yeah. Man, I'm fucked. I'm leaving my office tonight.
Bonk that fecking pork tenderloin.
Oh my God.
Linda's down there just beating it with a towel. Fuck this tenderloin.
Man, that tenderloin, I made that tenderloin. I seasoned it up nice. You season, this is what you do. You put your pan in the oven first. First, you gotta put your pan in the oven.
Oh, okay.
So the pan's nice and hot. Mm-hmm. All right? Then you season it up nice. And then you put the pork tenderloin in the pan when it's already hot. No, but when it's already hot, though, when it's already hot.
At four, throw it right on the
rack.
No.
At 425.
Okay.
You do it at 425. And then for about 15 minutes, you do a step down to about 400. And then you get it. And then when you take it out of the oven, you let it sit. Don't cut it right away. Yeah. You got to let it sit.
You got to let it rest.
You got to keep all the juices in there. And then you slice that baby nice.
I don't eat pork.
The problem is, I was literally 5 minutes away. I mistimed it by 5 minutes because what I was doing was, you know, the package that all that meat that we got in Elkhart, there's some bacon that's to die for. Mm. I mean, I'm talking, I'll bring it to work tomorrow.
Cook it at work? Cook it in my air fryer.
You could, or I'll bring it to you cooked. It is good bacon.
It's so funny because I just had a conversation with somebody. And we were both like, oh, we don't eat pork, but he was cooking bacon. I'm like, but I'll eat bacon. Bacon's not pork.
And that pork
it's
is
its own entity.
That's right.
Crystal, how do you or how are you supposed to properly introduce your dog to a guest or those who are family, especially those who come to the house? My dog has been recently growling and barking at guests, especially when pet. Do I correct when he growls or bark at guests? Some of the guests are not new, by the way, so they are not or should not be strangers to the
right.
dog.
It's not a stranger thing. This is the thing. Have you ever thought that your dog just doesn't like being pet by people and doesn't like pressure? So there's a lot of protocols we do to get the dog, to get the dog used to people. But for now, let's work on the existence concept. And this is the concept. Oh, I will correct you for growling, but then you know what? Go lie down over there. So this is how we stop a behavior right now. It sucks with an applied punisher to growl and bark at guests. Great. So you know not to do that now. Now, proactively, hey, place. Not because you're mad, not because you're upset. That's where I want you. And then tell everybody to ignore the dog. And then the dog just sits there and watches the world go by. That's how you stop an unwanted behavior immediately. Next.
Max is so cute. Just wagging his tail.
Yeah.
Maxina, Jeff, I hope you appreciate that wonderful, lovely woman, Linda, that you have as a wife.
Yeah, of course I do. Yeah. I sure as hell don't tell her what to do. I knew that was going to come across as wrong. This is what would happen.
I thought the same. Just like, so I'm like around the corner tonight and I get a call from Jeff. You know we have a show tonight, right? I'm around the corner.
Hold on here. Right. Hold on here. Oh, hold on here. I will freaking call NSA because they record every phone conversation out there. Every phone conversation.
He's on a roll tonight, bossing people around. Okay.
Every phone conversation is recorded. You know that, right? It's all archived. It's actually by a private company. Actually, it's archived and it can be sold. I just said to you, "Hey, don't forget we have a show tonight." I didn't say it in a bossy. Have I ever talked to you in a bossy tone?
No.
Okay. So just don't.
There was a text and phone call.
Because sometimes you don't get your text right away.
Okay.
And I know you've had a long day. I know we came home late last night, so the week might be like, you might have thought today was a Tuesday instead of Wednesday. And I was just being like, hey, don't forget we have a show. Mm-hmm. That's all. That's all it was. I never bossed you around. And I'm telling you, you're fucking boss. And I still don't boss you around because that's not my training style. Even on work, I don't boss you around. Come on, Joelle. Next. But I was hoping, this is what I was hoping would happen. I'm like, shit, I hope Romy comes up at a little bit after 8 with Angelo. Like, look, it's already 8:45 he came up. I hope Romy comes up with Angelo a little bit after 8 to put him to bed. And then I was going to say, hey, Romy, can you just ask your mom to please check on the pork? That's literally, I had it all planned out mentally. But then I'm like, shit, Romy ain't coming upstairs. What do I do? I had to do that.
Top chat.
Well, Donna Truett, $9.99. Next.
Cheryl, can't seem to go from low working level to higher stim with e-collar when I need to correct quickly enough to catch on time. What gives? So it sounds like she's just having trouble with the mechanics.
So if you're having trouble with the mechanics, set your collar to boost, plus 40 maybe. Learn how to do boost or keep it up on the higher level if you have to. Next.
Hallie, how do I train my dog to be okay with escalators and elevators? She won't even get on an escalator and freaks out inside the elevators. Thank you.
Well, but two different things. One is moving steps and one is an up and down floor. So let's pick the easier one of the two. How's your dog sit? How's your dog's down? So what you do is I go into when I do elevator training, they also don't want dogs on, even service dogs on escalators anymore. Actually, there's a liability. So, I mean, I've always had my dogs. We do escalator training all the time. Elevator training, stand outside the door. Door opens up, pause a little bit, walk in. I look to the right corner. I look to the left corner. I take the available corner, walk in. I go to the available corner. I sit. I down my dog, and then I stand next to my dog. So it's wall, dog, Jeff. So if anybody comes in, dog or human, they don't make contact with my dog. That's how you do it. Go up and down, up and down. The dog breaks command, no. Down. So your dog needs to know a good down for that. Escalator, your dog should know heel. Walk next to you, heel. What I would do first is find an escalator that's broken, that's been turned off. Go up and down that escalator, okay? So then riding escalator, walk on it, keep your dog next to you, and you go. A lot of it's also confidence building. If you've got a nervous, fearful dog, you're going to struggle. If you've got a confident dog, you'll do well. Like all the dogs that I, like if we do a dog for public access service training, these are dogs that can do it because they're confident. Also, find a staircase, the metal fire escape staircase or the metal staircase that are all metal. You can see through it and metal with no back. Go up and down those as well. Next. Oh, I got a top chat. $5 top chat from Ryan. Ooh, hope you guys are still doing date nights. Put it towards some pokey or something. And has been craving. Love you guys. Yes, this week we'll do a date night. Yeah, Mother's Day this week too.
Kyle, 4-month-old German Shepherd, fearful of things he didn't used to be. What went wrong?
Thanks. Nothing. He's going through a fear stage. He's going through a fear. Guys, everybody look up online fear stages in puppies. Fear stages in puppies. Look it up. Next.
Kyle said, 4-month-old German Shepherd. Oh, wait. He also has suspected hip dysplasia.
Okay. If you feel your dog has got hip dysplasia, number one, is it from a breeder? Then I would go to a vet and find out how bad. Usually you have to wait till the year anyway to get the true results. It maybe can be, you know, I would talk to a vet. But if it's going to be bad, the last thing you want is a one-year-old puppy that's a freaking a one-year-old dog that's just a bone wreck with its bone structure. It's gonna be rough. Donna 999, I use your technique of down command with a leash pressure. Oh my god, amazing. We saw my dogs went down on a pet shop momentarily. No yelling, no stress. We should never be yelling at your dog. But this is so funny. So Bogdana, the same technique that everybody freaks out about, putting the foot on the leash, putting the foot on the leash. My buddy Sean O'Shea from The Good Dog did a post on that of showing a dog, that dog Poop, who was like human aggressive, nasty biting dog, like would take your face off without blinking twice. And all he did was light foot pressure. Everybody's freaking out. Oh my god, if you ever kick that dog, what? You put the foot on the leash and gently put it. It was gentle too. Gentle. I'm not quite sure if people understand how dogs are actually fucking trained in the real world. Like, I'm not sure if people understand this. Like, you really think everything is fucking cookies and treats? And we do food training. There's a lot of dogs out there that don't give a shit about that. They still gotta train. And leash pressure is how you train them. So when you gently step on a leash, that's actually a really gentle protocol to do. It's not harsh. Next.
Batman, Linda, and Jeff remind me of Alice and Ralph from The Honeymooners.
Great.
James saying, love ya.
Sounds like a fucking judgment there. Who the hell am I? I think I'd rather be Alice, but she's not Ralph. You're trying to say that I'm Ralph Cramden? Nothing against fun. What? Do you know who Ralph Cramden is? Okay.
Top chat.
$5 top chat. Jenna, how long will you step on a leash for a dog that is really fighting the down command? The dog will not go down no matter what. This is it. You do a couple things. Have you tried it with a food lure as well? Food lure, leash pressure. Food lure, leash pressure. Also, if the front is down and the ass is up, push the ass down. If the ass is down, you can put pressure behind the shoulder blades. Do that. Try with a food lure too. Next. How long? Usually as long as it takes. Next.
Aldo says, we miss Angelo.
I know. I've been trying to get him to do a tip of the day, and he's like, I know. I'm like, well, fucking do one, kid. Next.
Victoria, I stopped doing pack walks because I was too frustrated when dealing with one of my dogs on his pulling problem is me. Now we have 5 AC, and I let my dog run and play. Chuck it for exercise. Is this okay?
Yeah.
Oh, five acres.
I barely walk my dogs. I barely walk my dogs. I swim up and run on. Next.
Victoria, do I need to make sure they do a pack walk? They have lots of structure.
No, fuck that. Fuck the pack walk. You're fine without it. Next. By the way, we have pack walks starting at the training center coming up. Next. It's more of a group walk. You don't need, guys, is walking your dog important? Yes. But you know what more important is exercising your dog in general. So if you're exercising your dog, throw some obedience into the exercising as well. Recalls, downs, impulse control, sits to down to sit, release and throw the ball. You'll be fine. Next.
Just like today, I like actually walked my dogs for the first time in probably like 3 months.
Yeah, but guess what?
The whole time they're just like, da-da-da. Like they'd probably rather be playing Chuck It.
Yeah, they exercise.
So I'm like, we go to the same 2 spots every day. Let me get them out. And they're like, can we go play Chuck It?
Right, exactly. Nina, by the way, you're going to come over and swim?
No, thank you so much. You are so awesome. He sits in place for hours and plays at work, then breaks for 15 minutes to eat, and I bring him out for potty, then places again for 3 hours, yep. Breaks again, and walk 15 minutes.
Yep, that sounds like a good freaking work day for you. Next.
Mackins, any seminars in Long Island, New York, in the forecast?
No, your Mackins, Providence, Rhode Island, is local to you. It's local. It's the only one I've got. I've got one coming up in Mantua, coming up. I just finished one. There's another one in Sharon Springs, which is farther away. But just jump on that damn ferry. Jump on the ferry. Go into New London and come on up 95. Okay? We're about an hour from the ferry, I believe. Next.
This person starred out their name. My four-month-old GSD still pulls with a 2.25 prong collar.
You're probably doing something wrong. It's 4 months old. Remember, it's not about putting the collar on the dog and holding on to the leash. It's about training. It's about training. So if you've got a four-month-old dog that you're having pull, you have to work on your leash handling skills and your healing technique and teaching the dog what you want. Most people, what they're doing is they put the collar on the dog, the leash is out front, and the dog pulls. Of course it pulls. The collar isn't what's doing it. The collar is a communication tool. Without the communication, you don't get the training. So watch videos on literally how to hold the leash, where to put the dog next to you, when to give information through the leash. Next.
Soggy outs, great fun watching and learning.
Awesome. Glad you're having fun. Next.
Donde, I will do the photos tomorrow for Instagram.
Awesome. Thank you.
Sunny, I'm planning to use a bonker for jumping. I've used off command for jumping, which obviously is not working.
Well, it's just a word.
You should use no or off.
I like, okay, to me, I like, do you ever want the dog to jump again? No. Use no. Next.
Kelly, prong works awesome for my 6-month GSD. We would like to eventually transition to a flat collar. Will he eventually generalize how he walks the prong collar to walking with a regular collar?
Why do you want to get off the prong collar? Why do you want to get off something that works? And who says a flat collar? So if you're like, well, I feel uncomfortable, okay. Or like you realize that a flat buckle collar can choke a dog and dog could die. So people think of a prong collar as a sign of weakness. I don't. I look at a prong collar as the most practical tool to walk your dog in, especially a German Shepherd dog, to have a better quality of life for yourself. I would literally want my dogs to be effortless. Now, I don't know your skill set. I mean, I can heal my dogs off leash next to me. It's a big deal, right? I'm a dog trainer. They're my dogs. Who cares? You can train other people's dogs to do that. But when you're walking, when you have a leash attached to something, why not have it attached to a tool that is a wonderful communication device that makes your life easier, that makes your stress levels go down? You can actually enjoy the communication between you and your dog. Next.
I don't know what this name is. Hi, I'm a dog trainer in Korea. I'm running my pet shop. I want to train some biting dogs peacefully. So I've trained biting dogs. I have some questions. Counter conditioning doesn't work to some dogs. They never eat in the pet shop or it takes too much time to train. How does it usually take for an aggressive dog to be trained? Thank you so much for always being honest and giving the best advice.
No problem. I'll say
that was a different one. Sorry.
So I think I did say that right. Annyeonghaseyo? Annyeonghaseyo? This is the thing. How long does it take? I don't know your skill set. I don't know your skill set. And also, different dogs are a little bit different. Every dog's a little bit different when it comes to, like, how well do they take a punisher? Do they take it really well? Do they understand it? How long have they been biting for? Which sometimes doesn't matter because you can still stop it quickly. A lot of it has to do with the dog and your skill set. So I have no idea. But also, we don't counter condition aggression. We punish aggression. And then if you want to do counter conditioning after that, you can. But it all depends on how strong your punisher is. And then I think when I say goodbye, I would say, Annyeonghaseyo. Next. Sorry. I'm trying to remember my Korean.
Melissa posted the link to the seminar.
Awesome. Thanks.
Jasmine, I have a well-behaved puppy, but my fiance dog is very stubborn. She lets him do whatever she wants. Will the puppy start learning that behavior from the other dog?
No, because that's going to be called an ex-fiance, and your dog will just do fine. Next.
Megan, friends just told me her dog broke her fence by fence fighting. She tells me that she'll stop when she asks, but then will constantly whine and pace. Thoughts?
She's doing it wrong. Get a remote collar, and hopefully this is enough to fix the problem. And you get a remote collar, you put it on the dog, make sure it's proper fit. I turn it up all the way. Dog fence fights, hold the button down on continuous for 3 seconds, make it suck. Make it suck. So this is the thing, guys, if you ran into the show, notice how all I ever do is talk about punishment. But listen to the questions. Listen to all these questions. This is what people have to understand. When the people always have to put the context in the show. Nobody's teaching me how to do a sit, place, recall, down.
Right.
Everybody wants me to stop stuff. It's really funny because so many dog trainers don't want to talk about any of this stuff. They try to sugarcoat it. Mm-hmm. Make fence fighting suck. That's how you stop it. No, no, no. Try to create positive association with the dog on the other side. And when it doesn't fence fight, reward it. I'm like, great, wonderful. In the meantime, while the dog is fence fighting, what do you do? Like, how many more fences? How many more fences have to break? How many more fences have to break before we fix this problem? Or how about never having to worry about another fence anymore by making it suck? I'm just blown away. I'm just blown away why people are afraid to be a straight shooter. You know, they have no problem fucking punishing me and attacking me, but they don't want to talk about punishment when it comes to dogs. Mm. Such a weird thing. Anyway, next.
Ginger Beaches of Hawaii had to stop overexcitement from our dog when we returned home and let her out of her kennel, jumping, running around, etc.
Bonk. No, bonk. And then you're going to hear a lot of people go, oh no, then that'll ruin the relationship. No, it won't. The dog will be scared to see you. No, it won't. Because you're going to say no first, and then you're going to deploy your punisher. You'll be fine. As long as you don't say no, your dog will be fine. When you say no and you follow up with a punisher, your dog will stop the unwanted behavior and then you don't have to worry about it anymore. Next.
Jasmine also questioned, do you treat when teaching recall and heel, or do you go straight to e-collar and prong?
No, you can do treat. We do a ton of food training. Usually not for heel though. Heel is a hard one. That's bigger in the sport dog world, I think. It's hard to do food rewards on a walk. And we're not doing focused heel or anything like that. So, but for recall, tons of food rewards. Next.
Hallie, thank you so much for all your videos. They've helped me and my dogs a crazy amount. We've made such great progress since discovering you.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you.
Blake, how long does an e-collar last work effectively on average, the ones you use?
What do you mean work effectively?
Like the lifespan of them.
The lifespan? Oh, depends on your usage and how long. You know, they're waterproof. I mean, I've used them in the ocean a lot. I don't know. I mean, the ones we have at the training center, we use every day, sometimes on multiple dogs. We've probably had them for 3 years.
Yeah, some of those are definitely old.
Yeah, we've had like...
Antennas falling off.
Yeah, we work those collars. We work those collars. So, and the goal, keep in mind, guys, once your dog is remote collar trained, it's not like you're prompting every time. You're barely using it. Sometimes you may never use it. I mean, I used to run a pack of 10 dogs off leash, and 8 of them had remote collars on. And I had 2 Dotra Edges, which are the 4 dog units. I had just 2 of them, so 2 handsets. And every dog had the same collar. Like, I always know who, because they were my dogs. So I always knew which, each dog had the same collar, and I always knew which handset they were in, you know?
Yeah.
And we'd be out there for an hour. So 10 dogs, 1 hour. I probably had to make a correction 2 or 3 times. Not to every dog, but total. Mm-hmm. It's total.
Yeah.
That's it. Once dogs are trained, it's just for literally like, oh, you're not recalling. You're still sniffing something, or you're blowing me off. And once they're trained, it's not like you're prompting with these. Next.
Dino, former Skyper with Samoyed and Baby. Baby was crawling, walking, and wobbling. Dog's been doing good for 2 months since speaking with you, and today growled, barked.
Yep.
Corrected high. He left room, brought him back in room, and he looked away and made better decisions.
Good.
Did treat protocol after that, left positive. What would the next step be in this situation?
Good. You did exactly.
Between them?
Sorry, no. So you remember what I told you? I don't know if I told you this in the Skype, but once they start crawling, shit gets real. And once they start walking and hobbling, shit gets real with the dogs. What I would do is this: your child is old enough to understand the word no. Put your dog in place, make a little boundary around it, like with a leash, and you really, really tell that child, don't cross the boundary. Make sure there's plenty of distance. And also, never, ever, ever leave them alone, even for a split second. Never take your eyes off them. If you feel safer, you can always put the dog in a crate in the living room, the room you're in, lying down, calm. But again, don't let the baby like go up to the crate. So sitting in a crate, observing the world, might be a good step right now. That might be a good step. But a fence, can create barrier frustration. Well, the crate's a barrier too. For some reason, it's a little bit different. Next.
Clint Compton, is kitten working spot sold out, unable to see on site?
If you can buy a ticket, then no. So if you can buy a ticket to the Canton workshop, you know, it's not sold out. Next.
Scaredy Floof, my dog listens to me and my mom well, but often growls at my dad when he tells him to do something. Should my dad correct him, or does it matter who does the correction?
Say that one more time. Who says the command?
The dad.
If the dad says the command, if it's a remote collar, I don't care who's holding the controller, but your dad has to say the no. Yes, the dad has to say the no, or you'll discredit the dad. Next.
Best Behaved Pups says, wow, someone gave you $24.99 top chat.
Yeah, we've gotten $50 top chats. People appreciate our stuff. Yeah. Yep. Next.
Melissa posted the link to the seminars for Clink.
Awesome. Thank you.
Dino says, not buttering up. Love you guys.
Thanks. Love you too, Dino.
Best Behaved Pups, training a young Frenchie to behave in a crate. When hit him with the bunker, he gets more agitated. Any suggestions?
Yeah, you might be underwhelming the dog. You know, these damn Frenchies, man, woof, they can be challenging. So this is the thing. You do what works. So sometimes we absolutely, if we bark the crate, the dog can escalate. So what you can do is you can walk over to the crate, hit the side of the crate, hit the top of the crate, do an earthquake on the crate. Believe it or not, you can open up the crate, bonk then. You can also get a pet convincer, which is compressed air. Do that as well. And also, when you've got these, say how old the dog is?
Young Frenchie.
Okay, I don't know what young means. I mean, young can be underneath a year old. But if it's 3, 4, 5, 6 months old at a minimum, you can use a remote collar on a dog. Believe it or not, you can use a remote collar for crate nonsense. A lot of the people say, don't do that. It'll create a negative association. That's the biggest lie in the world. Next.
The couple will order a later one at $199.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, for some reason, for the top chats, under $499, it doesn't go to the top. It shows in the normal feed. So I apologize for anybody we're not recognizing right away. Next.
What order of steps from dog reactive to playful?
I don't have enough time in the Skype. And I don't know your skill set. I don't know the dog. So we would stop the reactivity as step one. Go into existence, step two. We have no idea if the dog will be playful or not. We don't know. So stopping it. Our role is stopping the reactivity and getting the dog to exist. There's usually not enough time when the dog's on our watch to go to playful. And we don't know if the dog will be playful. It might not be. It might not be playful. Every dog is not playful. So also it might be selective who it's playful with. But as far as the protocols, that's a Skype. And I'm not trying to get you to spend money. I'm saying it's a very, very involved process. So you're taking you want to take a dog that's leash reactive, maybe aggressive, to playful. That's a very long process. Next.
Supreme Leader Snoke, Angelo is adorable. Good job, Dad.
Thank you. Angelo is a cool kid. Next.
The couple, I was at the Dallas seminar about 3 years ago with my deaf pit.
Oh, wow.
I love the prong collar, but want to interact with my friends' friendly dogs. What is the next step after I master the prong collar?
Wait, say that one more time. I don't understand what your friends' dogs have to do with it.
They want to interact
with their
dog.
The dog with a dog?
Yeah.
I don't remember the dog. So is their dog aggressive?
It just says my deaf pit.
Okay, so this is the thing. Again, I don't recall your dog as far as like its behavior and behavioral problems. We have to just look at it this way. There's their dogs, your dog, the dog's owners, and there's you. That's four variables that all have to work in sync in a certain way. And I don't know any information about it. Just because you want your dog to interact, that doesn't mean your dog is capable of interacting. So, who's breathing so hard? Why is this dog breathing so hard? Is it warm in here? So there would be, I would need a lot more information, a ton more information. And it's not a prong collar conversation. Like, this is all going to be done without, like, without a prong. Like, this is not necessarily a tool conversation. It's a philosophy conversation, but it's also a learning theory conversation. And then it's also a, you have to understand body language. You have to understand intent. Then you've got to understand how to shut down certain behaviors. And then you have to understand, do you put your dog into avoidance? Does your dog stay in existence? And then you've got to be able to get a read on the other dogs. And then you've got to be able to make sure the other owner's on board. And how about if the other dogs are doing things that would make your dog maybe be set off? You got to shut down. You got to shut down those dogs, not shut down dogs, but like shut down the behavior. There's that factor. There's all of these things, factor in when it comes to dog issues. $5 top chat. Pups, Karen. Oh, the Frenchie is 9 months. Oh, Karen, just get yourself a remote collar. Absolutely. Just say, it's just knock it off. Knock it off. Thanks, Karen. Next.
Kelly, Mitch and I are so excited to hear you like our bacon.
Oh my God. Love the fucking bacon.
You just like already made it. You were just like, hey, I'm gonna make some of this bacon.
Last night I was taking stuff out of the RV. I took the stuff out of the fridge because the stuff in the freezer is in the RV. The freezer stays on in the RV, so that's fine. Oh. So I was in a rush to get that. The stuff was in the refrigerator. When there was a ton of it, I wanted to get back in the freezer here. Mm. So I was putting it in the freezer. Most of it's beef hamburger.
Yep.
So it's all the same size packages that I just stacked up. Then there's a couple of other packages that are different. There's some ground turkey in there for you. There's different. And I'm like, oh, what's this? Pork loin. Uh-huh. That's going in the kitchen. And then there was like, it's sliced ham, which is bacon.
Yeah.
Sliced ham. And I'm like, that. So that I put in the fridge. I opened it up and I cooked it off. We need more. I'll make you some tonight. You want to make you some tonight? Mm-mm. You sure?
Yeah.
I may not even be allowed back in that fucking kitchen after that little nonsense.
Probably not.
I know. Next.
Angela, do you have a video that processes the best way to work through prong collar objections?
No, because there's a lot of variables on that. So what I would do is, don't get upset. Don't be stressed. Work in low environmental issues. Work on a slowly moving back and forth. Understand pressure. So don't do pop. Do a little bit of pressure on, pressure off with it. Try that. Next.
Be healed dog training, not pregnant again, still pregnant, LOL.
No, so that must have been- no, what I meant was it's not Charlotte. So in other words, you have Charlotte, duh, you know that, you're the fucking mother, right? And then I saw you holding Charlotte.
That was in like October. Well, so it really wasn't that long ago.
No, right. That's what I meant by pregnant.
It just seems so long ago, but it's not.
But Rachel, when I saw you,
she was like not showing.
You weren't showing, and you didn't even like, you hinted that you were pregnant. It wasn't like, ta-da, I'm pregnant.
Yeah,
it was like,
never know.
It was like a hint that you were carrying again. And I was like, holy shit, you're pregnant. So it was like, so I forgot.
So Charlotte is already in bed. I know she'd want me to tell you guys hello. She's getting really good at taking care of her chickens.
Tell Charlotte I'm really proud of her. And, hopefully those eggs are coming out nice and yummy. All right. And every time you pick eggs out from the chicken coop, make sure you thank the chickens. Say thank you, chickens, for these wonderful eggs. Next.
Kim, good evening, Jeff. I'm sorry I don't know the young lady's name. I hope things are going well with you, Linda, and the family.
This is Joelle. And then is that what you meant by this lady? Yeah, this is Joelle. Linda was the woman that came in here that I was groveling in apology to. Next.
Kim says your audio is not doing too well.
Has anybody else mentioned that?
No, I think somebody down here though said it's a YouTube issue.
Okay. Yeah, I think the audio, I mean, if you can't hear me, I'm freaking screaming. Next.
Brandy, does anyone know if any dog carriers for a 60-pound dog, something easily portable? I'd like to get them on MTA buses, trains for transportation.
60 pounds? I can't imagine anything other than a crate. Next.
Kyle says, thanks. I've had him at the vet who put him on anti-inflammatories, waiting for x-rays Monday. I'm devastated.
Yeah, you might have to make a decision on that one. Next.
Hey, it's Christy. I use e-collar technology e-collar on my Doberman. How do I know if it's too tight? I know the box shouldn't move and it doesn't, but it seems too tight.
If your dog passes out, it's too tight. Most owners think it's too tight, but it's not. So how do you know? You know, on a Doberman, you can probably get away with the regular contact points. Make sure you rotate it every 4 hours, every 5 hours. you know, I've never seen really an owner do it. Here we go. Ready? Switch to a bungee collar. Get yourself a bungee collar. You're taking the box, putting on the bungee collar, and you'll never have to worry about if it's too tight anymore. Next.
Bogdana, I never yell, but I see a lot of other people do.
Yeah, got it. Yes. The only time I yell is on my show. When I train dogs, I'm actually silent. Next.
Brandy, I feel like my dog only learned down because of the foot pressure trick. So helpful.
Yeah, probably. What the hell? How do you think we get dogs to down? You know, and this is the thing. When I tell my dogs to plot and they go flying down, you wouldn't know how I did it. You wouldn't know. What'd you use? A food load, Jeff? Hell no. He's fucking leash pressure. Next.
Kyle, I also can't get in touch with the breeder, surprisingly.
Surprisingly. Yeah. That's going to be a hard one. I mean, if you've got a dog with extreme hip dysplasia, 4 months old, that's a vet conversation. And I know a lot of people are uncomfortable with it, with me even talking like this, but we've seen dogs that are just in pain. They're in pain at 9 months old, and their gait is horrific. And I'm not talking about, oh, you need to have a dog that looks good. I'm talking about, like, no, it's just not physically good for the dog. Next.
Christine, the under the leg trick for Dan.
Under the leg pick two is good when you put your leg up in it. We do that with a lot of small dogs. When you put your leg up like you're bending it, like you're going to be doing sit-ups, and then you take a food lure and you lure the dog underneath your leg. It goes to a down. You mark it. Next.
Clint Compton, how do I get my dog to take interest in retrieving ball more than once or twice?
I don't teach forced fetch. So I just have high drive, you know, ball dogs. So, I mean, but I've also owned dogs that didn't give a shit too. So all my shepherds, my Malinois, all have got ball drive. I never taught them fetch. Ronan, my Kangol, didn't give a shit. Big Mama, my Pity, she didn't care. So I don't know how to teach it. Next.
David, our GSD bear, who is coming up to you guys soon, has a habit of taking the kids' food and toys. How do we handle
it? Ooh, we'll make it suck. Use a remote. Start that now. David, get yourself a remote collar if you don't have one. We'll fix that in a day, so don't worry. On a day, we'll fix that in like a minute. And you just teach the dog out. Next.
Tara, hey, Jeff and Noel.
Hey, how are you?
Kyle. Sorry, by the way, I love your videos. I watch religiously from the UK. We are all naive, positive only people. I love you guys.
Hey, listen, man, I love the UK. I love doing a seminar over there. So I'm not, you know, it's a wide paintbrush stroke. That's probably because you do have a good amount of hate over there. You do. You got a lot of, I love it over there. This is the thing. Wherever I travel, like, you travel with me now. Like, I meet the most wonderful, fantastic, awesome people everywhere. Literally. Restaurants, hotels, coffee shops, supermarkets. Wherever I go, man, I see beautiful people, wonderful people, happy people, friendly people everywhere I go. Everywhere I go. I'm loving it. I've got great conversation. I'm one of these people that start conversations all the time.
You know exactly who they are right
now. Who?
The hostess.
Oh, the hostess. The hostess in Seattle. Oh, my gosh.
She's a riot.
She's the next swinger. I could pick out a swinger a mile away. Yeah, she was like, Jesus Christ. Like, it's like, hold on here, lady. Yeah. But in the UK, I had a great time as well. I was in Scotland and I was in England and I went everywhere and I meet fantastic people. The issue is, though, you've got a lot of angry freaking people over there who are just mean. They're mean in a lot of ways. And it's just multiplied over there. And I guess I'm an easy target for them because they pile up like fucking like flies on shit. I'll tell you that much. Next.
Deanna, do you correct a dog for redirecting?
Oh, yeah.
Biting me out of refusal to comply or becoming aroused due to seeing another dog.
Okay, so comply. Let's make sure about that. Does the dog know it or not? Let's talk about redirecting on you for leash reactivity. Hell yeah. Redirection is a choice. Now, if you're putting too much pressure on the dog during some obedience training and the dog doesn't know the command well enough, you might not be being fair. So, but if the dog absolutely knows the command, refusing to do it, You apply pressure, it bites you. Hell yeah. Redirect. I mean, correct. $10. Leah, 2 weeks of training a Roddy on a decal, reactive to cars, wonderfully walking now, but tail low, so she looks shut down. Your dog's not shut down. No. Tail down does not mean shut down. Tuck tail does not mean shut down. Would you do a class with the owner even though the dog doesn't look ideal? Huh? What do you think? I work with perfect dogs? Would I do a class? I don't understand your question, Leah.
Like a mid-training or something, maybe? Like, is that what they mean? Like a class? Like a...
I don't understand. But yeah, I mean, dogs, your dog went to reactive on a car to walking by a car. It's not going to look perfect. It's not going to look perfect right now. So, but I'm not sure what you mean by would I do a class? If you're a dog trainer and you want the owner to come in and see the work you've done? Yeah, absolutely. If that's what you're talking about. If you want to know, would we personally do a class? I don't understand what that means. Hey, if your dog is nervous or fearful, of course we'll do the class. Next. Mm-hmm. I want to be helpful here, Leah. I just don't understand your question. Next.
Podrick, are dogs better than cats?
I have no idea. Next.
Julie, love you guys. Son Anthony was super excited to watch your dogs on IG after he messaged you guys the other day.
Awesome.
By the way, e-collar and prong have changed my life. I used to be so scared of them.
Yeah, I know. A lot of people are. Good. Congratulations.
Karen, nice. GSD lover, my dog occasionally growls at me. He wears an e-collar from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. Now he growls at me when I'm removing the collar at night. He growls as I unsnap it. Suggestions? Thanks.
Yeah, bonk him. No, and then bonk. Next.
Angie, one-year-old GSD is terrified over fly swatter, among other things. What to do over irrational fears? Also, recently became unhinged over two-year-old visitor while in crate. What can I do to help him not be crazy?
Well, it's not about help. Well, you are helping him. You correct the unhinging with a shock collar. Make it suck to do that and tell the dog to lie down. As far as the fly swatter, you do a typical counter conditioning protocol, which is all clicker food fly swatter. And that's all just about using a combination of a little bit of space, and you're moving in the distraction, the environmental in, and then you're figuring out how far you can move it in, and then you're marking good reactions and then rewarding it with food. Next.
Christy, how do you get a German Shepherd Hound mix, one-year-old, to stop bolting out of kennel when released and sprints through the house? No. I have both e-collar and prong collar.
Neither. And it doesn't make a difference to breed. This is what you do. You ready? Number one. The kennel up, dog goes in the kennel, close the door, open up the door a little bit. As soon as that dog tries to nose in, slam that door as hard as you possibly can. Boom. Wah! That's what you do. No, you tell the dog to stay. No, you don't. You make it suck to bolt out of crates. Don't worry, that dog will stay. You do that a couple of times, then put a slip lead on the dog, call the dog out, put him into a sit. But you don't do that first. That's step two. Step one, make it suck to run out of kennels. Step two, let me teach you how to walk out politely. Got it? Don't do step two first. You do step one first. Next.
Kyle says, I'd love for you to do a seminar over here.
Where's Kyle again?
UK.
Oh, yeah. I am in 2020. In England, Scotland, I'll be able to have. Scotland, I got a location. I need to find a location in England, though. Next. It has to be safe. The host can't be a wuss. The host of the building or the location can't bow to public pressure. So I need a host with a set of fucking cojones that can tell all these assholes to fuck off. And maybe you think that's harsh, but I had to move my seminar four times in London. I'm doing a seminar for 50 people. 50 people, that's it. It's a voluntary transaction seminar. Everybody wants to be there. They want to be there. It's like, no, don't let Jeff Gellman show 50 people how to use a shock collar. Our whole freaking monarchy will come crashing to the ground. Oh my gosh, what's going to happen? That's it. Four locations I had to change. File police reports. I got death threats. I got anti-Semitic slurs. People freaking disrupting my business, just making threatening my life. all because I want to do a dog training seminar in England. Right? That's it. Just want to go over there quietly, come in. Everybody that was there wants to be there. They want to be there, but no. Massive, massive problems over there. I'll be there again. I would open up a fucking location in the UK just to piss fucking people off. Just to let them know you don't bother me. And there's groups over there. And try it again this year, guys. Try it again this year. I got a lot of data on all these people now. It's one thing I did was I hired a fucking researcher. Some of my biggest haters over there, some of the organizers of some of these organizations, these hate groups. I've been doing my homework. Okay. Information is key. I've been doing my homework. You want to start blasting me? Okay. I'll fight this. This is one seminar location. I will fight fire with fire. Okay. You come on. Let's go. You bring it on. Until your human resource department gets a call and some screenshots and some background information on who works for their company. Yep. Yep. No way. Not this time. Not this time. We're picking a location and we're protecting it. Because there's people over there in the UK that are struggling. They're struggling and they deserve to get the proper information and they deserve to be able to train their dog in a way they want to train their dog, and they deserve to go somewhere where it's safe and not be harassed. So, nope. Next. I'm going on tangents tonight, aren't I?
Really?
I know, and you're tired.
Bronwyn, I just feel like I'm actually getting sick for the first time in a long time.
Really?
Yeah.
Hmm.
Hi, guys. First time catching you live. I currently have a spot in your Vancouver seminar. Since starting with an e-collar, I've been able to stop most of my dog's bad behavior. Should I still bring her?
Oh, God, yeah. Yeah. Bring another dog if you want to. It's still a little bit off. Hell yeah. We'll have fun. But if you want to bring another dog, bring another dog next.
Kyle says, I'm from Newcastle. I know there's a lot of apparent positive training people. However, there's a lot of people that just want results.
Thank you. So Kyle, find a location that's safe. Find a safe location. All right. Central, some hotels by it, some restaurants by it. Safe, meaning I can't rent out a hall. So the place can't be like, this is what's going to happen. Just so Kyle, just so you know, in the back of your mind, how it'll work. I announced the seminar at a location. Whoever owns the property, whether it's a landlord, if it's somebody that owns the building and they don't give a shit, that's what I need. Because they're going to get 1,000 between phone calls and emails they'll get. And then the newspaper gets called and they come down and do a story on it. I mean, this is how big it gets. Me, like, you got to be fucking kidding me. I'm doing these for 1,000 people all over North America. Every other fucking country I do these in. But whenever I go there, it's like the biggest hassle. And I lose money. I'm doing the UK. It's what they call in retail a loss leader. I literally lose money doing this seminar. And I still want to fucking do it. Why? People are struggling. People are struggling over there. And now I'm going to fly her over too. I'm even going to lose more money.
Sorry.
No, you're worth it. What I'm saying, because now you get to document this shit.
Yeah.
Next.
Top chat. $5.
$5. This is the last question. Brandy, this is my TV show. I stand up for this. I appreciate all your content and great advice. Thank you guys. Take care of yourselves. Great way to end the show. Joelle, sorry you're not feeling well. Hey, everybody. Okay. Madly in love with you. If you have not subscribed, subscribe to the show. Hit the notifications. And the seminars are not quite like this. And training in our training center is nothing like this.
No.
Man, this show is out of control tonight. What was up with you?
This show.
What was up with you tonight?
What are you talking about?
You were out of control.
Me?
Yeah.
It's like the quietest I've ever been on a show. I'm literally just like trying not to lose my voice because I have a long week ahead of me.
For all my secret people out there that sent me screenshots of her facial expressions, right now, when I said that, she made this facial expression. Get those facial expressions. Get that screenshot into me, guys. Get it into me. All right. I love you guys. Okay. I really do. Hey, Joelle, thanks for doing this tonight. Mm-hmm. I appreciate it.
Happy to.
I appreciate it. All right. Thanks. Take care.
Bye.